Now trimetal bearings. Trimetal bearings have on the steel intermediate layer, which is mainly copper based and contains lead or lead and tin. Now we are developing lead-free intermediate copper-based layer, but the current material contains lead. And the overlay, lead-based overlay on the copper surface. You see three types of intermediate layers. The difference between them is in the concentration of lead and tin. The higher the tin content in the material, the higher the hardness of this material. Tin increase in this case, not in the case of aluminum, where tin is solid lubricant. In the case of copper-based material, tin is dissolves in the matrix and increases its hardness. Lead serves as solid lubricant, but unfortunately, copper is very bad in its seizure properties. It is not able to work with steel without overlay. Overlay is must here. We have two kinds of overlays. The first one is conventional trimetal bearings overlay, which is lead-based, contains 10% of tin, 3% of copper. Why tin is added? Tin is added to prevent corrosion of the overlay. Tin imparts corrosion resistance to the overlay. This is the function of tin. The function of copper, 3% of copper, to increase hardness of this material and load carrying capacity. We increased copper content in the material that we are selling as a high-performance trimetal bearings to 5% to increase load carrying capacity of this material. This is the overlay that we are using for high-performance trimetal bearings. You see that its hardness is 15 as compared to the hardness conventional trimetal bearing, which is 12. But it is not the last layer. Between the overlay and the copper or intermediate, there is very thin nickel barrier. The thickness of nickel barrier is 40 millionths of inch. The function of nickel barrier prevent diffusion of tin, which is in the intermediate. Diffusion of tin, this 10% of tin, from the intermediate, from the overlay into intermediate. If tin diffuses to the intermediate, the content of tin is overlay goes down and the corrosion resistance goes down. Okay, now this material, K796, or we call it GP, gold performance material. This is our last development. This is high strength trimetal bearing, high strength trimetal material. It doesn't contain a lead-based overlay. The overlay is totally different. The bearing looks like this. This is our GP bearing. This material has, first of all, the intermediate layer of this material is harder. We are using copper with 10% of tin in order to increase hardness of the intermediate layer. It is important because this material is designed for highly loaded engines, and in this case, the load carrying capacity of intermediate layer, not only the overlay, is important. So we increase the hardness and the strength of intermediate layer by using this kind of intermediate layer. You see, 10% of copper, 10% of tin, and 10% of lead. This is the second layer, copper-based material, and the third layer, it is thin layer, you see the nominal thickness of this layer is 0.4 inch. It is based on a metal, I can't say what metal, but it is based on a metal, not lead, lead-free, and it contains solid lubricants. The hardness of this material is higher, much higher than the hardness of lead-based overlays. But anti-seizure properties are also good. This is a unique combination of good anti-seizure properties and high strength, high load carrying capacity. These are the applications of our GP bearings. First of all, it's racing engines. Okay. We tested these bearings in one of Ron Shaver's engine. The test conditions were extremely severe. In order to increase the load applied to the bearing, we produced a groove on the bearing surface. So we reduced the bearing surface about two-thirds of the original. So the load applied to the bearing was 40% higher than the load applied to the bearing with full surface. And we tested it under the torque of more than 500 libras foot. The test was very successful. It continued about 1 week. And now we are supplying such bearings to Ron Shavers for his engines. The second application is turbocharged and supercharged gasoline engines, where load is higher than in naturally aspirated engines. And the last, it is direct injection diesel engines. Not only direct, but also indirect. But diesel engines, where combustion pressure is very high, may reach 220 bars. These are the comparison of our materials, most of our materials. On the left side you see the aluminum-based materials. On the right side, copper-based trimetal materials. You see the load carrying capacity. This is the material with tin and copper, only tin and copper. This load carrying capacity 5,800 psi. The addition of silicon increases its load carrying capacity to 800 psi, and heat treatment with the proprietary additives, you remember, increases its heat, its load carrying capacity to 14,500 psi. The copper-based trimetal bearings, the conventional trimetal is 8,700 psi. This is the high-performance trimetal bearing with load carrying capacity 10,200 psi, and this is the GP bearing, 17,400 or maybe more. I would like to say few words about this. Sorry. About this material. These are the examples of this material, which is called. XP. This material is not. It looks maybe different from conventional trimetal bearings. This is the result of special post-plating treatment, which increases its surface hardness. It doesn't increase the hardness of the whole overlay. It increases the hardness of very thin nanoscale surface layer, and as you know, fatigue cracks. It starts from surface and then it propagates through the material. And if the surface is hardened, this surface inhibits formation of fatigue cracks. It's something similar to shot pinning, but the treatment of these bearings was different. It is some kind of chemical treatment. Okay, these are the characteristics of different bearing materials, not only fatigue strengths, but other properties of bearing materials. You see the fatigue strengths and soft properties of the materials. Usually, the higher the fatigue strengths, the lower the its surface properties. But sometimes there are some exclusions. For example, in trimetal bearings, the fatigue strength is relatively high, but not so high as in the GP bearings. But the soft surfaces, if the misalignments or embedded particles have the dimensions which are larger than the thickness of the overlay, the soft surface of this the surface properties of this material is very bad, because if the thickness of the material is about 5 tenths of hundredths of inch and the particles are larger, it couldn't be absorbed.